Hi friends, I'm Sumati here. Today we are going to discuss history, and today's topic is the Vedic culture. In this topic, we will be going to discuss the origin or home of the Aryans and the Vedic literature and their importance, and Rigvedic age and its culture, the later Vedic age and its culture. These are the topics that we'll be going to elaborate, we'll be discussing in detail. So let us get into today's discussion. The cities of Harappan culture had declined by 1500 BC. Consequently, their economic and administrative system had slowly declined. Around this period, the speaker of Indo-Aryan language, Sanskrit, entered the northwest India from the Indo-Iranian region. Initially, they would have come in a small number through the passes in the northwestern mountains. Their initial settlement were in the valley of the northwest and the plains of the Punjab. Later, they moved into Indo-Gangetic plains. As they were mainly a cattle-keeping people, and they were mainly in search of pastures. By 6th century BC, they occupied the whole of North India, which was referred to as Aryavart. This period between 1500 BC and 600 BC may be divided into the early Vedic period or Rig Vedic period, or 1500 BC to 1000 BC, and later Vedic period, or 1000 BC to 600 BC. So original home of the Aryans. The original home of the Aryans is the debatable questions, and there are several views. Different scholars have identified different origin as the original home of Aryans. They include the Arctic region, Germany, Central Asia, and Southern Russia. Bala Gangadhar Tilak argues that the Aryans came from the Arctic regions of astronomical calculations. However, the theory of Southern Russia appears to be more probable and widely accepted by historians. From there, the Aryans moved to different parts of Asia and Europe. They entered India about 1500 BC and came to be known as Indo-Aryans. They spoke the Indo-Aryan language like Sanskrit. Vedic literature. The word Veda is derived from the root Vidha, which means to know. In the other word, the term Veda signifies superior knowledge. The Vedic literature consists of the four Vedas, Rig, Yajur, Sama, and Atharvana Veda. The Rig Veda is earliest of the four Vedas, and it consists of 1028 hymns. The hymns were sung in praises of various gods. The Yajur Veda consists of various details of rules to be observed at the time of sacrifice. The Sama Veda is said to tune for the purpose of chanting during sacrifices. It is called the Book of Chants, and the origins of Indian music and traced it in. The Atharvana Veda contains details of rituals. Besides the Vedas, there are other sacred works like the Brahmanas, the Upanishads, Aranyakas, and the epics Ramayana, Mahabharata. Brahmanas are the treaties relating to prayer and sacrificial ceremony. The Upanishads are philosophical texts dealing with a topic like the soul, the absolute, the origin of the world, and the mysterious of nature. The Aranyakas are called forest books, and they deal with the mysticism, righteous and rituals of sacrifices. The author of Ramayana was Valmiki, and the Mahabharata was Veda Vyasa. Rigveda age, or early Vedic period, that is 1500 to 1000 BC. During the Rigveda period, the Aryans were mostly confined to the Indus region. The Rigveda refers to a Sapta Sindhu, or the land of seven rivers. This includes the five rivers of Punjab, namely Jhelum, Chenab, Rabi, Bias, and Satluj, along with the Indus and Saraswati. The political, social, and cultural life of Rigveda people can be trace it from the hymns of Rigveda. Political organization, the basic unit of the political organization was kula or family. Several families joined together on the basis of their kinship from the village or grama. The leader of grama was known as gramini. A group of villages constituted a larger unit called visu. It was headed by the vishyapati. The highest political unit was called Jina or tribe. There were several tribal kingdoms during the Rigvedic period, such as Bharatas, Matsyas, Yudas and Puras. The head of the kingdoms was called as a Rajan or king. The Rigveda polity was normally monarchical and successions was hereditary. The king was assessed but Purohit or priest and Senani or commander of the army in his administration. There were two popular bodies called Sabha and Samiti. The former seems to have been a council of elder and later general assembly of the entire people. Social life, the Rigvedic social society was patriarchal. The basic unit of society was family or grama. The head of the family was known as Grahapati. Monogamy was generally practiced while polygamy was prevalent among the royal and noble families. The wife took care of the household and participated in all the major ceremonies. Women were given equal opportunities as men for a spiritual and intellectual development. There were women poets like Apala, Vishwavara, Gosha and Lopamudra. During the Rigvedic period, women could even attend the popular assemblies. There was no child marriage and the practice of sati was absent. Both men and women wear upper and lower garments made of cotton and wool. A variety of garment ornaments were used by both men and women. Wheat and barley, milk and its products like curd and ghee, vegetables and fruits were the chief articles of food. The eating of cow's meat was prohibited since it was a sacred animal. Chariots, racing, horse racing and dicing, music and dance were the favorite pastime. And the social divisions were not rigid during the Rigveda period, as it was a later Vedic period. The economic condition of Rigvedic period was the Rigveda. Aryans were pastoral people and their main occupation was cattle rearing, and their wealth was estimated in terms of their cattle. When they permanently settled in North India, they began to practice agriculture with the knowledge and use of iron. They were able to clean forest and bring more lands under the cultivations. Carpentry was another important profession, and the availability of wood from the forest cleared made the professional profitable. Carpenters' products and chariots and the ploughs, workers in metal made a variety of articles with copper, bronze and iron. Spinning was another important occupation, and cotton and woolen fabrics were made. Goldsmiths were active in making ornaments. The porters made various kind of vessels for domestic use. Trade was another important economic activity, and rivers served as an important means of transport. Trade was conducted on barter system. In the later times, gold coins called nishka were used as a media of exchange in large transactions. Religion, the Rigvedic period religion was, the Rigvedic Aryans worshipped the natural forces like earth, fire, wind, rain and thunder. They personified these natural forces into many gods and worshipped them. The important Rigvedic gods were Prithvi. Prithvi means earth, Agni means fire, Vayu means wind, Varuna means rain and Indra means thunder. Indra was the most popular among them during the early Vedic period. Next in importance of Indra was Agni, who was regarded as an intermediary between the gods and people. Varuna was supposed to be the upholder of the natural order. There were also female gods like Aditi and Ushas. There were no temples and no idols worshipped during the early Vedic period. Prayers were offered to the gods in the expectation of rewards. Ghee, milk and grain were given as an offerings, and elaborate rituals were followed during the worship. Later Vedic period, the Aryans further moved towards the eastern later Vedic period. The Saptapada Brahmana refers to the expansions of Aryans to extend eastern Gangetic plains. Several tribes, groups and kingdoms were mentioned in the later Vedic literature. Sorry. One important development during this period is the growth of large kingdoms. Guru and Panchala kingdom flourished in the beginning. Parikshita and Janamejaya were the famous rulers of the Guru kingdom. Pravahana Jaiwali was a popular king of the Panchala. He was a patron of learning. After the fall of Gurus and Panchalas, other kingdoms like Kosala, Kasi and Videha came into prominence. The famous ruler of Kasi was Ajatashatru, and Jataka was the king of Videha. With it as capital at Mithila, his court was adored by scholar Yajnavalkya, and Magadha, Anga and Vanga seems to be the easternmost tribal kingdom. The later Vedic text also refers the three divisions of India. Sorry. Aryavarta, northern India, and Madhya Desha, that is central India, and Dakshinaprata, that is southern India. Political organization. Large kingdoms were formed during the later Vedic period. Many Jana or tribes were amalgamated to form the Janapadas or Rashtras in the tribe later Vedic period. Hence, the royal power had increased along with the increase in size of kingdom. The king performed various rituals and sacrifices to strengthen his position. They include Rajasuya, consecration ceremony, Ashwamedha, horse sacrifice, and Bajpaya, chariot race. And the king also assumed title like Rajya Vishwa Janan, Ashwa Biju Biyu Vanapati, Lord of all earth, and Ekrath and Samarth, the sole ruler. In the later Vedic period, a large number of new officials were involved in the administration in addition to the existing Purohita, Senani and Gramini. They include the treasury officer, tax collectors and royal messengers at the lower levels. The administration was carried on by the village assemblies. The importance of this smithi, the Sabha, has diminished during the later Vedic period. Economic condition of Vedic period. Iron was used extensively in this period, and this enabled the people to clear the forest and to bring more land under the cultivation. Agriculture became the chief occupation. Improved type of implements were used for cultivation. Beside barley, rice and wheat were grown. Knowledge of mature was another improvement. Industrial activity became more varied, and there was a great specialization. Metal work, leather work, carpentry and pottery work, great progress. In addition to internal trade and foreign trade become extensive. The later Vedic period, people were familiar with the sea, and their trade become extensive. The later Vedic people were familiar with the sea, and they trade with the countries like Babylon. A class of hereditary merchants came into existence. Vaishyas also carried on to trade and commerce. They organized themselves into guilds known as Gnanas. Beside Nishaka, the Rig Veda period gold and silver coin like Satamana and Krishnala were used as a media of exchange. social life of Rigvedic period, the four division of society, that is Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra or the Varna system, was thoroughly established during the later Vedic period. The two higher classes were Brahmanas and Kshatriyas enjoyed privileges that were denied to the Vaishya and Shudra. A Brahmin occupied a higher position than a Kshatriya, but sometimes Kshatriyas claimed a higher status over the Brahmins. Many subcastes on the basis of their occupations appeared in this period. In the family, the power of the father increased during the later Vedic period. There was no improvement in the status of women. They were still considered inferior and subordinate to men. Women also lost their political rights to attend assemblies. Child marriage had become common. According to Aitiriya Brahmana, a daughter has been described as a source of misery. However, the woman in the royal household enjoys certain privileges. Religion. God of the early Vedic period like Indra, Agni lost their importance. Prajapati, the creator, Vishnu, the protector, and Rudra, the destroyers, become the prominent during the later Vedic period. Sacrifices were still important and the ritual connected with them become more elaborate. The importance of the prayers declined and that sacrifices increased. Priesthood became the professional and hereditary one. The formulate for sacrifice were invented and elaborated by the princely classes. Therefore, towards the end of this period, there was a strong reactions against princely dominations and against sacrifices and rituals. The rise of Buddhism and Jainism was the direct results of these elaborate sacrifices. Also, of the Upanishads, which is the essential of Hindu philosophy, and turned away from the useless rituals and instead on true knowledge of Jnana for peace and salvation. With this, we will be ending the Vedic period and we'll do a quick revisions at what are the things that we have learnt in this lesson. The Vedic literature such as the four Vedas and the Brahmanas and the later Vedic literature we have learnt in this lesson, and the Rig Vedic polity, society and economy we have learnt, religious life of Rig Vedic people we have learnt in this lesson, and the changes during the later Vedic period in the sphere of polity and society. And we also learned some of the increasing rites and rituals of the religious life and the later Vedic people. So with that, I'll be leaving some of the model questions for you to revise this lesson. The earliest of Vedas, I have given four options. Please try to answer by yourself. If you're not able to answer this question answer, please go back and watch this video once again. That will help you to answer for this question answers and the dashes and match the following and choose the correct answer. Pravaha Jaiwali was a popular king of Dash. Four options I have given. Fill in the blanks. That author of Ramayana was Dash, and the archaic home of the Aryans was suggested by Dash. Match the following I have given and select the correct statement. One statement alone is the right one. And write a short note on any of three topics, that is Vedic literature, original home of the Aryans, and position of women during the Rigvedic period. Religion of Rigvedic period, and answer briefly for 100 words. Write note on Rigvedic polity and mention the religious life of later Vedic people. Give a brief account of socio-economic life and Rigvedic Aryans and assess the political and social conditions during the later Vedic period. I hope these classes are helpful for you guys. Do like my videos and subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you and have a great day. Bye.